Hey guys, how are you? I hope you are doing well. So welcome to our channel. So as you know friends, on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have multiple series on our channel in which we focus upon your prelims as well as mains. So friends, you might be aware of the fact that we have started a brand new series, the name of which is Let's Check Your Progress, in which what we will be doing, we will be daily picking up a topic out of your syllabus and we will be asking you questions from it. So this video, this series or video will help you in analyzing how well are you performing and where are you lacking and where you have to improve upon. So let's see what is the topic for today. Yesterday we covered, yesterday we covered polity. So today we will be covering, we will be covering geography. So first is the coal resources of India are available in. First statement is Old Gondwana formations of peninsular India. Second, Young Tertiary formations of northeastern region. So which of the above are correct? So it is an easy question, friends. You might be aware of it. If you have read the NCERTs, you will be able to mark its answer. You can pause the video and can think upon it and can then mark. So the answer that I'm going to tell you is C, that is both 1 and 2. So important coal bearing areas are Raniganj, Jharia, Karanpur, Bokaro of the Modar Basin in Odisha, and then Pench Valley is there in Chhattisgarh and Madhya Pradesh, and then Jhingurda coal seam is also there in Chhattisgarh. So tertiary rock system belongs to Cenozoic era. So final breakup of the Gondwana land occurred in this era, and Tethys Sea got lifted in the Himalayas. So rocks of this era have valuable deposits of both petroleum and coal. So hard coal deposits spread over 27 major coal fields are mainly confined to eastern and south central parts of the country. So the lignite reserves stand at a level of around 36 billion tons, of which 90% occur in the southern state of Tamil Nadu. So this was the first question, and now let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following about Saharia tribes. First, they are migratory tribes and regionally belong to South West Asia. Second, they can be found living in Central India. Third, they do not follow any religion and worship only natural forces. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you friends that only one statement is correct, and that is second. So the answer is D. So they are found in Central India. So statement 1 and 2 is Saharia is basically indigenous Munda speaking tribe in Madhya Pradesh province of India. So they are mainly found in districts of Morena, Shiopur, Bhind, Gwalior, Datia, Shivpuri, Vidisha and Guna districts of Madhya Pradesh and Baran district of Rajasthan. So why it is important? Because they are on the list of particularly vulnerable tribal groups. And the statement 3 is, some sources indicate that they take part in Hindu festivals and worship Hindu gods and goddesses. So obviously it is clear that they follow, if they are follow Hindu practices, then how they can be atheist and also how they can be claimed to be following just natural forces. Obviously they are following some gods as well as goddesses as well. So now let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about the Deccan Plateau of the peninsular India. First, the eastern Deccan Plateau is made of vast sheets of thick limestone rocks. Second, the northwestern part of the plateau is made up of lava flows. So which of the above statements are correct? We have to choose that. So friends, only one statement is correct, and that is second. So the northwestern part of the plateau is made up of lava flows. So the answer is B. So statement 1 is, it is made of basically large sheets of granite and not of limestone. So it effectively traps rainwater. So under the thin surface layer of soil is the impervious gray granite bedrock. And then rocks are spread over the whole of Maharashtra and parts of Gujarat and Madhya Pradesh, thereby making it one of the largest volcanic provinces in the world. So thick dark soil found here is suitable for cotton cultivation. Now let's move to the next question. Next is, tribal groups are at different stages of social, economic and educational development, particularly vulnerable tribal groups being one of them. Which of the following is not a necessary characteristics of a particularly vulnerable tribal group? A, stagnant or declining population. B, pre-agricultural level of technology. C, absence of social hierarchies. D, extremely low literacy. So this question might be easy for you people, because obviously you might be aware of the fact that C is not it's not a necessary characteristic. So if their population is declining or it is stagnant or they are following pre-agriculture level of technology and they have extremely low literacy, then they can be in the list of particularly vulnerable tribal groups. So tribal communities live in various ecological and geoclimatic conditions ranging from plains and forests to hills and inaccessible areas. So while some tribal communities have adopted a mainstream way of life, at the other end of the spectrum there are certain scheduled tribes, 75 in number, known as particularly vulnerable tribal groups, who are characterized by pre-agricultural level of technology, stagnant or declining population, extremely low literacy and subsistence level of economy. And now let's move on to the next question. Next is, some of the major coal belts of India in Jharia and Raniganj are affected by mine fires and coal subsidence. According to official sources, what is the primary cause of this? A. Unscientific and illegal mining leading to self-combustion of coal. B. Geologically young coal formations in these regions. C. Global warming and climate change. D. High price of coal in these regions. So answer is A, unscientific and illegal mining leading to self-combustion of coal. So basically Jharia is famous for a coal field fire that has burned underground for nearly a century. So first fire was detected in 1916. So flames at Jharia have been recorded reaching heights of 60 feet. So fires are believed to have started through spontaneous combustion or what is sometimes called self-heating caused by oxidation of minerals in the exposed coal. So this is about your discussion of 5 questions. So if you like this discussion, then do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends. And lastly friends, just a minute, let me there is a lot of messages, we have discussed this. And in case friends you have scored 3 to 4 marks or 5 marks, then you are obviously performing very well. But if in case you have scored less than it, then don't worry about it. You can improve, and obviously there is time available to you people to improve. So there is not you will be hanged tomorrow if you haven't scored more than 3 or you haven't attempted even one of the questions. So you can streamline your preparation, you can streamline your way of study, and for this purpose we have multiple series on our channel that help you in preparing well. So we have also all geography NCRT series, which will be covered from 6th to 12th in a time bound manner and in a target framework. So daily target will be given to you, and even in the evening you will get 10 MCQs from that target. So all NCRTs of geography from 6th to 12th will be covered in 45 days. So in this way you will be getting 450 MCQs based upon the NCRTs at the end of the 45th day. So also a single magazine will also be shared on 45th day, which will be the compilation of all 450 NCRT based MCQs. So how this initiative will benefit you friends? Obviously NCRTs, if you are aware, they are the foundations of your preparation. So each and every NCRT will be covered, and coverage will be entirely through MCQ mode. So mostly today students are preparing from home, and due to which they lack self-discipline and they do not follow a time-bound preparation strategy, due to which their syllabus keeps lingering. So for that purpose, this series, if you join, this will ensure necessary discipline in your studies, because you will have a framework of 45 days in which you will be required to complete the NCRTs, and also then problem of revising NCRTs will be solved, because at the end of the day you will be getting a single magazine of 450 MCQs in which all important topics that are there in the NCRT, they will be covered in that magazine. So obviously, and you might be aware of the fact that geography NCRTs are widely believed as the most comprehensive NCRTs. If we compare these NCRTs with other subjects. So, and other thing is that mere reading is not enough. You must know how the UPSC frames question. What is the trend in the UPSC? How MCQs are being asked in UPSC, and what is important for UPSC? So that is that unless you practice questions. The reading will help, will be of little help for you people. So then other thing is the discipline preparation gives you much needed self-confidence, and obviously now is the best time to start and cover all the NCRTs, because prelims is just 6 months away. Don't waste your time and don't start too late, and obviously if you value your time and career. So if in case you are interested, then you can join using this link that is shown on your screen, and this will also be provided in the description box. So you can check the link so you can join our initiative. And other thing which we want to say is that you can join also our public Telegram channel, where we have more than 14,000 subscribers which are following us and are getting access to our various public resources that we share with them for the CSE preparation. And in case if you have any doubt queries, then you can check our contact number and mail ID in the description box, and can then further communicate with us if you have any queries. So this is all about from today's video. Thank you. Have a very nice day ahead.